Hello, hello, I'm Li Hao. Today we're going to talk about bindings. Wait, we talk about bindings. But there's a lot of examples, a lot of things that you can cover about bindings. And I'm not going to cover all of them. To be honest, you should learn yourself. And I'm going to show you where you can read about them. So over here, I am at this Svelte Tutorials. So Svelte prepares... Svelte in the main official docs, it prepared a very amazing tutorials, step by step. You can come over here, start from the day one. Most of the things we have covered. And what I'm going to show you now is you come over here and you look for bindings and you see text inputs. This is where it starts. And from this drop down, you probably have seen that, you probably will see that there's a lot of things that you can do bindings with, right? Text inputs, numeric inputs, checkbox, group inputs, text area, select, content editable, media, dimension, this, components, a lot of them. Some of them I'll cover, for example, component bindings and like text input element bindings. I have covered some of them, but some of them I would not cover. You can explore yourself. So I'm going to show you how you can explore yourself. So you choose one of it, say I'm going to come over here and numeric inputs, and it will show you that it will tell you things that you need to know about. For example, if you have a numeric inputs, then you set type equals number or type equals range, then it will make it into a numeric input, which means that the value will become a number before assign it to a variable. So bind value takes care of that for you. So it will show you, for example, in this example over here, some example that has prepared, but I believe we don't have bindings here. And if you click show me, you replace the code with bindings and then you see that everything works now. So you can compare the before and after, you can reset and show me to compare yourself, quickly toggle and see what's the difference and then play with it, right? Change this. This is a REPL, the same REPL that I've been using all the while. So you can play around and learn about it. So today, what I'm going to cover is group inputs, because I find that it's slightly different. It needs more explanation. Hopefully, you are smart enough, you don't need my explanation, but I believe maybe with my explanation, or maybe some people might need it, maybe with my explanation, you make it clearer. Right? Hope I do that for you. If you feel that I have make it very clear, thumbs up, comments, share this video out to everyone else. Right? So I'm gonna come over here with a REPL that I have prepared. So what is group inputs? Right? So group inputs it actually means that you can bind a group of inputs with a bind group. So this binding is called bind group. And what you do is you can bind two kinds of inputs with this. Only two kinds. It's either a radio button or a checkbox button. Right, so radio button is one that you usually see with a circle where you have to choose single option. And checkbox is usually when you see that it's a square boxes where you check and uncheck, you can have multiple choices. So what this bind group does is that instead of making your own group of checkbox by setting them the same name, you should set them the same name, but besides just setting the same name, what else you can do to say collect all the values from these inputs together and assign it to a variable? What you can do with is you use you use bind group. So say for example, if I come over here, I have already three checkboxes, value 1, 2, and 3. What you usually do is I should remove this, sorry. Let me remove this first. What you usually do is you should come over here and name it, say, foo. I'm bad at naming. Let's come up, foo. And I'm going to use radio for now. Radio. So with the same name, you expect that you can only choose one of them, right? If I create one more for, you expect them to only choose one. And how do you bind the value of this group to a variable, right? I want to bind it to a value. You can't say, because radio, usually you have a property called checked. So do you do like bind checked? But this will only bind the checked to a variable and bind the value of the checked of like this want input. How do you bind a group of inputs? Because it works together, you want to say this group of input, I want to know which value is being selected. So what you do is use bind group instead. So I can bind it to a variable. Over here, I'm going to say, come create a variable called options. Come up here, say options. Option. Selected option. So if it's radio, then you can only choose one option. And so I'm going to come over here and bind it to option. So one. So it should be... Naming is important. I'm going to use a singular noun. Right, I'm going to use a singular noun. And I'm going to paste this bind group over here. Bind group. Oops, sorry. Bind group. Now, this variable now becomes... Sorry. Let me... I have my camera just blocked my view. So I'm going to resize this a bit so that I can see it clearly. So if I select, you can see that the option... The current option selected will be assigned to this variable called option. All right, so it depends on the value. So what you have to make sure the value is not you have to make sure, but whatever is select, whichever radio input is selected, the value of that variable, value of that input will be assigned to this group variable called option. Right, so the option variable will be assigned to whatever input radio button that is being selected at the moment. So this is a binding, which means it's two-way. If I come over here and initialize with say tree, you should with a string tree, you would expect that this string tree will be selected by default. And if I come over here, I have a button, reset. Okay, I'm gonna. This function will try to set option to say 4, right? I change and I say, click this. Oh, sorry. I click once and I click reset. Set the option value to 4 and 4 is selected. Right? So I can bind group, which is the group of inputs. What is the value of that group of inputs with bind group? And it works with check boxes as well. So I'm going to come over here, comment this out so that you can play with it later on. And come over here, paste this, and I'm going to replace all this with checkboxes. Checkbox, 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 and checkbox. In most cases, checkboxes, you have multiple selections, right? So most likely, what you want is more of like an array of selected options. So you use array instead. And for the sake of naming, it should be a plural. Form, so it's options. So I'm gonna change it to options, 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 options. And just to show it nicely, I'm gonna join with a comma, right, and a space. So whenever I click unselect, select and unselect, you see that it will add all of the selected options to this variable called options. So it's an array, it will add more items to that array. And because it's a two-way binding, I can change this value of options. I can come over here where on click on this, I will select 1 and 4. Right? So I can select something, I can select 2, and I'll click reset. I'll select 1 and 4, and 4, 1 will be the value of the options. So bind group allows you to bind a group of checkboxes or a group of radio input where checkbox, when you bind group, you bind you expect to pass in a array as a variable, right? Because you can select multiple inputs, select multiple checkboxes, so all the selected checkboxes, the value of them will be the value will be They will collect all the values of the selected checkboxes into an array, and that array will be assigned to the variable that you are binding with. Right? So say if I have, now if I have two variables, I have options and options two. Come over here and have another variable. Now this will allow me to have collect the options two will only bind to checkbox 3 and 4. So anytime when I change the value, I check and uncheck the value of 3 or 4, it will collect them and then assign it to this options 2 variable. And then you will see whether options 2, what are the inputs that is selected by options 2, right? And it works two ways. So whenever you change this variable programmatically, then you will get reflected by all the variables, all the inputs boxes that binds group on that input. So that's all. Hopefully that is useful for you when you want to have a group of radio boxes or check boxes. Reminds you of using bind grouped to bind them. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you learned something or you're unclear of, comments down below. And as always, subscribe to my channel so that you get notified when the next one is out. So see ya, bye bye.